After some years away, I'm at the Dave's house in London again, far from my home in India. And one burning question hangs in my mind. It's harder to meet Sunil than the Pope himself, and I'm not even a Catholic.
I've already explained. It's not possible.
All right, so he's in Birmingham. But surely I can go there and visit him for the day?
He's busy in the law firm all week, and then when he comes home, he's...
He's so tired that he goes to sleep.
He must be the only youngster in the Western Hemisphere without a mobile phone.
Well, that's just it. He hasn't got a mobile phone.
I find this very hard to believe.
Sunil's always been an oddball. He has his own ways.
I find the whole thing very odd. I mean, there must be some way of meeting young Sunil. He's my favorite nephew, Geeta. I'd be damned if I've come all this way and not even be able to see him.
Thanks for this, Dad.
Your Uncle Ravi's been here for a week. He's been asking questions about you. Where have you disappeared? When can he meet you? When you had your breakdowns before, I used the excuse to say that you'd gone to Birmingham.
Birmingham?
Well, you stayed there for 3 years at a uni. I think it's a good idea.
The Birmingham story goes down well with most of the family. But Uncle Ravi's a wily old fish. You can see it doesn't add up.
Uncle Ravi rocks.
Rock or no rock, he's asking too many questions.
Sunil, you're going to have to show up.
I'd love to see him again.
Just for appearances.
I know. He can pretend to come down from Birmingham for the day to pick up the hard drive for his laptop. He can show up for dinner, then disappear back to the hospital. Or Birmingham afterwards.
Why can't we tell Uncle Ravi the truth, man? That I'm a manic depressive with delusions of grandeur?
That's nonsense.
Listen to me. I've bought you a jumper so you can tidy yourself up. Got to look alert when you come round. Avoid those mad staring eyes you like to use. Learn how to break eye contact.
What's she on about, Dad?
You've got to behave as if you're doing well. Be confident. Say you're working for a law firm.
Think of yourself as being a success.
How?
Try to be as normal as you can.
What do you mean by normal?
If you want to look normal, just lie low, okay? Just stay out of the conversation as much as possible. If Uncle Ravi asks you a question, just smile or mumble something.
Remember to smile confidently. If you radiate a winning smile, all will be well.
Show me a smile, Sunil. No, no, that's not it.
You're supposed to be enjoying it, Sunil.
That smile will frighten anyone.
For fuck's sake, this is all bullshit!
Why do you make it so hard for me to love you?
Is that the way to talk to your seniors?
You bring this illness upon yourself, Sunil. Too much negative thinking, and all the while you think you're some kind of artist because of it.
It's not my fault I'm in here.
It is. You've got to learn to be strong. Be a brother I can be proud of.
I am trying.
Sunil, you've got to behave yourself today. Look, I can ask the nurses to arrange a day out for the hospital for you, but only on one condition. You do exactly as we say.
All right. I'll do what you say.
Good.
Geeta, which law firm did Sunil join up with in Birmingham?
I don't remember.
Thank you.
Sunil!
I can't believe you're here, Uncle. It's fantastic.
I can live for 2 months on a good compliment like that.
Hey?
Ah, better. Better. Are you all right, Sunil?
Just smiling at you, Uncle. I'm doing well. Feeling confident.
Good.
I'm 100% normal today, Uncle. I have to go to the toilet.
Boys will be boys.
I'll get the dinner together.
Sunil has a good appetite, Hannah.
The food I've been getting lately is just awful.
Where's that?
He means at the Diggs in Birmingham.
Ah, Birmingham. And which law firm are you working with, Sunil? It is polite to look at the person that you're speaking to, young man.
I don't like to use these eyes on you, Uncle. I'm learning how to break eye contact.
What?
I'm thinking of myself as a success.
He's with Chambers Cavendish. It's a big firm in the Midlands.
Sunil is a paralegal there.
Could I have some more wine, please?
Oh, for God's sake, Sunil, you imbecile!
I may not agree with what you say, Lakshmi, but I shall defend to the death your right to shut up. Okay? Nitin, I'd like to have a private word with Sunil. Sunil, bete, do you like gardening?
I hate it. But I like smoking out here.
Do you remember how I took you to the Tower of London when you were very little?
Crown jewels were nice.
These bastard English people stole the Kohinoor from India.
These bastard English are the ones who are looking after me now.
How?
Shit. I'm gonna be late.
Late for what?
I have to be getting back.
Back to Birmingham?
Yeah.
Ah, better. What's it like working in the law firm? It must be exciting being a paralegal.
It's all right.
What's the matter, Sunil?
I'm so sorry, Uncle.
Sorry for what, my boy?
I'm a bloody liar.
Liar?
I'm not really in a law firm, Uncle Ravi.
What?
I'm in the Mark Twain ward.
Where's that?
I'm practicing law at Goodmayes Hospital.
Here.
I had a nervous breakdown, and it wasn't the first time.
My God. When was that?
In my final year at uni.
Oh. Was it schizophrenia?
The doctor calls it bipolar disorder. It's also called manic depression.
Oh.
Have you heard of it, Uncle?
Yes.
Bitch of an illness to have.
I must make an admission to you, Sunil. My daughter Rekha suffers from the same condition. And I haven't told anyone in the family. Yet I'm sure they all know. It's an open secret. I am not ashamed of it.
Christ. I wish my family wouldn't be ashamed of me.
There's nothing to be ashamed of, Betty. Huh?
I'll take Sunil to the station. He has to get back to Birmingham.
Nitin, I know the truth about Sunil. My own daughter Rekha suffers from manic depression, but it's nothing to be ashamed of. We're not ashamed of a broken leg. So why a broken mind? It's something that we have to face and not hide from.
You mean Rick has been in a mental hospital? Mm-hmm. Good God.
It's not the end of the world, Lakshmi.
Yeah, but...
Rekha has had the best care possible. Is Sunil going to the National Health Hospital? Good. So I hope he gets better soon with the help of all of us.
My brother is right. I'm not ashamed of Sunil's condition. You're gonna be fine. You'll be all right. Tu to maro rach dularo.
Thanks, Ma.
I'm sorry if I've been hard on you. It's my fault and it wasn't very nice. I'll try not to let it happen again. I say things without realising. I just want what's best for you, that's all.
You don't have to stick the knife in.
I didn't mean to hurt you, Sunil.
You have hurt me with the things you say over the years. Sometimes I really hate you. Where do we go from here?
To a new beginning?
So Big Mouth doesn't strike again.
I'm sorry. It'll be different in the future.
So, Sunil, this is your Birmingham.
I'm sure Sunil will join the law firm one day. Not too long from now.
Actually, Dad, I may not become a lawyer.
What?
I might become a writer.
A writer?
Nitin, some of these writers earn astronomical sums of money. Look at J.K. Rowling. She started off in a council estate.
I don't know if I could spend the rest of my life behind a solicitor's desk.
He will write a bestseller.
Whatever you do, I'll be proud of you.
Thanks, Dad. When will I see you again?
Well, Betty, my flight to New Delhi isn't till next Tuesday. So how about it if I come and visit you every day till then?
I don't want you to go.
Come to India and stay with me. Your cousin Rekha would be delighted to have you staying with us.
Will you be able to handle two manic depressives under one roof, Uncle Ravi?
Yes!